Welcome to CSE Guru. In this session, we will discuss about types of operating system. The different types of operating systems are categorized into batch operating system, multi-programming operating system, time-sharing system, multi-processor operating system, distributed, network, real-time operating system, handheld operating system, and desktop operating system. So, we will discuss one by one in detail. First, batch operating system. In this operating system, the user will submit the jobs offline to the computer operator. The computer operator will group the similar requirement jobs into a batch, and that batch will be submitted to the computer for execution. The operating system will execute the jobs present in the batch in FCFS basis, that is first come first served basis. Once the execution of this batch is completed, the allocated memory is released automatically. Then the computer operator will prepare the next batch, and that will be submitted for the computer for execution. So in batch operating system, the advantages are simple scheduling, that is the jobs present in the batch will be executed in FCFS basis. Also, the jobs will not compete for CPU. So here, very simple memory management, IO management, and device management. Disadvantages, if you are considering, the user will not interact with the computer directly. And there is no specification for job priority present in the batch. Also, when the job needs to wait for the IO devices, that time the CPU will sit ideal. Multi-programming operating system. In this operating system, several jobs will be competing for the CPU for execution. Initially, the job will be placed in the job pool. The operating system will pick one of the job from the job pool, and that will be assigned to the CPU for execution. When the executing job needs to wait for the IO devices, the CPU will switch to another job. That is, the operating system will pick another job from the job pool, and that will be assigned to the CPU. Even when that job needs to wait for some IO devices, the CPU will switch to another job, and so on. So likewise, the operating system will keep the CPU always busy. So here, if you are considering the advantages, this operating system will support multi-user or multitasking environment, and here CPU is always busy. Also, it executes more number of jobs in less time. And the disadvantages, if you are considering, since it has to deal with more number of jobs, it is more complex task. Also, which job will be picked from the job pool and assigned to the CPU for execution. So for that, CPU scheduling is required. Since more number of jobs are on and off with the CPU, it requires critical memory management. Next, time sharing operating system. This is a logical extension of the multi-programming operating system. This operating system supports interactive user environment. So in this operating system, each job will be assigned a time slot or time slice for executing with the CPU. For example, if you are considering, the CPU is assigned with this particular job with user 5. So here, the CPU will execute this job only for the assigned time slot. Once the time slot ends, means the CPU will switch to the next job, and it will execute that particular job for the assigned time slot. Once this time slot is also over, the CPU will switch to the next job. So likewise, the CPU time will be shared among the different jobs. So the advantages of time sharing operating system is it enables user interaction, and equal priority is given to all the jobs. Also, it enables high resource sharing. And the disadvantages, if you are considering, since it has to deal with more number of jobs, and each job will execute only for the assigned time slot, difficult memory management, IO management, and file management. Also, complicated CPU scheduling is required. Next, multiprocessor operating system. In this operating system, more than one processor will be available for execution, and they are in close communication. Since more than one processor will execute simultaneously, it is also called parallel systems. These systems will share the resources like computer bus, system clock, I/O devices, and memory. There are two types of multiprocessor operating system. One is symmetrical multiprocessing and asymmetrical multiprocessing. In symmetrical multiprocessing, each processor will have its own operating system, and these processors will communicate with each other during execution. And here, memory is shared among different processors. In asymmetrical multiprocessing, one of the processor will be assigned as a master processor, and the remaining processor will act like a slave processor. The master processor will only assign jobs to the slave processor, and these slave processors will not communicate with each other. Only the communication is between master and slave. And in symmetrical multiprocessing, any processor can run the OS task. But in asymmetrical multiprocessing, only the master processor will run the OS task. And the advantages are increased throughput. Since more than one processor is available for execution, we can execute more number of jobs. And high reliability. Because since many processors are available, if any one processor fails, the remaining processors will be available for execution. Also, the resources will be shared among the processors. The disadvantages, if you are considering, complex operating system is required since it has to deal with more number of processors. And also, this kind of operating system is expensive to implement. In case of symmetrical multiprocessing, the processors will share the memory. So, it requires large main memory. Next, a distributed operating system. In this operating system, the individual systems present at different places will be connected via the communication network or the shared network. During execution, these individual systems will communicate with other systems via this communication link, and also they will share the resources among this network. So in this operating system, suppose if one system fails, it won't affect the execution of the other systems. The other systems will continue its execution. These kind of systems are also called loosely coupled systems. So the advantages of this operating system is scalable system. That is, we can add any number of individual system with this communication network, and we can increase the computational power. The available resources will be shareable among all the computers connected to this network. And also it will increase the reliability. That is, the failure of one system will not affect the execution of the other systems. And disadvantages, if you are considering, if the communication networks fails, means the execution of all the systems will get affected. Also, to set up this network, it will incur initial cost. Network operating system. In this network operating system, centralized server will be there. And all the terminal computers will be connected to this centralized server via LAN, that is local area network. The available resources like printer, memory, files and software will be shared among the terminals via this centralized server. Example, it is a typical computer lab. Advantages, if we are considering, stable centralized server. That is, through the centralized server, we can easily able to communicate with the terminals. In this operating system, it is easy to upgrade the system whenever it is required. Also, it enables remote access. Disadvantages, if you are considering, the cost of the server system is expensive. All the terminal systems has to rely on the centralized access only. Suppose if the server system fails, means the terminal system cannot able to communicate. Also, in network operating system, regular maintenance and updates is necessary. Next, real-time operating system. These real-time operating systems are time-restricted systems that react with the input very fast. And in these systems, each task will be assigned a deadline. And these systems has to complete the task within the specified time or deadline. Also, the system needs to generate the correct output within the specified time. Otherwise, it may fail. Example, medical image processing, industrial control systems, scientific experiments, etc. There are two types of real-time systems. One is hard real-time systems and soft real-time systems. These hard real-time systems are otherwise called critical restrictive systems. In these systems, each task will be assigned a specified time or the deadline. These systems has to execute the task within the specified time or the deadline. Otherwise, it may cause a permanent damage to the system. Soft real-time system. These systems are otherwise called less restrictive systems. In these systems, missed occasional deadlines is acceptable. These systems, if it cannot able to execute the task within the specified time limit or deadline, we can reschedule the task and it won't cause a permanent damage to the system. So the advantages of real-time systems are, these systems are task-oriented system. That is, it has to execute the task within the specified time. These systems has to execute the task without any error and it should be executed within the time limit. And the resources will be utilized to the maximum. Disadvantages, if you are considering, since it is a time restrictive system, only limited number of tasks we can able to execute with these systems. And the resources required for these real-time operating systems are expensive. And we need a complex algorithms to execute the task. Next, a handheld operating system. These handheld devices are portable computing devices which are easy to use and carry anywhere. It has limited screen size and computing power. It includes mobile phones, PDAs, tablets, etc. In these devices, the OS supports with many features like touchscreen, video camera, GPS, navigation, Bluetooth, infrared, Wi-Fi, voice recorder, and speech recognition. Example, Apple iOS, Google Android. The advantages of these handheld systems include they are portable device, smaller in size, the operating system provides easy user interface. Disadvantages include smaller screen size, performance is limited to battery life and limited speed. Next, desktop operating system. These systems are individual user system with easy user interface. It consists of CPU, monitor, keyboard, mouse, etc. And these systems are used by a single user for common applications like word processing, spreadsheet, internet access, etc. Since this system is used by single user only, available resources will be dedicated to that user only. So no resource sharing is required here. Example, Microsoft Windows, Apple Mac OS, Linux, etc. Advantages, it is a single user system. And their available resources will be dedicated to that individual user only. Whenever upgrade is necessary, it is easy to upgrade. Disadvantages includes it is not portable and also it occupies space. It should be connected to the power to work. These are all the different categories of operating systems in use. Thank you for watching this video.